Okay. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, my student. This is my first class, seminar class for the Carol Dunham. Because the new syllabus of BHMS from the last two sessions, just 2 years back, it was started, last two years. And Carol Dunham, 6 chapters of the Carol Dunham and 10 chapters of the Richard Hughes and chronic disease. It was entered in the syllabus, but the new thing have been added in your syllabus. So I first took the classes when I was physically attended over there. Now I am Calcutta, so I am attending here through the Zoom app by online seminar I'm doing on the Carol Dunham. Thereafter, I will go through the Richard Hughes, the 6th chapter of the Carol Dunham. I think already you have obtained or procured the book from the library and purchased the book. You please purchase the book. This is very important book in your practice life. This will be very, very much helpful. Apart from the other philosophy books and Organon book of Harriman, Kent and other. And you please purchase this workbook. Obtain you can, this book is available through Amazon and from your medical shop at Nagpur, you may obtain this book. Library, there are two books of the Carol Dunham, and I have also donated one. When I leave Nagpur, I donated one. And you please go through the book by collecting from before purchasing this one. Today, I will speak on the Carol Dunham. Screen is visible? Okay. Screen is visible. The name of the book is The Homeopathy, The Science of Therapeutics. You please procure this book. The Principles of Homeopathy, The Science and Therapeutics. And 6 chapters of it included in the final year syllabus. This is the picture of the Carol Dunham. The Carol Dunham who born in New York on 29th October 1828. He graduated from Columbia University in a modern medicine with honors in the year 1847. And thereafter, he received the MD at the College of the Physicians and Surgeons of New York in the year 1850. 1843, Hahnemann died, you know. While he was in Dublin, he received a wound, dissecting wound, and that wound nearly killed him. Thereafter, he took homeopathic medicines with some friends, Swiss friends, and it cured. Actually, he was an allopath surgeon, but converted homeopath. And he cured by the lachesis for the dissecting wound. And thereafter, when he observed the magical cure of homeopathy, and he visited so many homeopathic hospitals in Europe, and then he went to Munster, where he stayed with Bonninghusen over there, and studied the methods of the homeopathy, our master contribution, with the help of Bonninghusen. And he became a good writer, voluminous writings. He wrote in different books. And for 25 years, he contributed different articles on homeopathy. As an allopath, as a surgeon, he converted to homeopathy when he saw the magical cure of lachesis for his own dissecting wound, when he got during surgery and cured. And most important books are lectures on Macrium Medica. Please obtain, procure this book. please, this is very, you are final students, therefore I am giving advice to you. Please procure this book, my student. And the homeopathy science of therapeutics, on which I will discuss on different classes, will continue for a prolonged period from so many days because 6 chapters are included. Under the stress of the large practice, because he had good practice during that time, he developed ultimately rheumatic carditis of himself. And he fell into trouble owing to his own carditis. Then all the old school specialists gave him allopathy medicines but failed. But ultimately, homeopathy saved his life. And his friend, Dr. Herring, Herring was very close to him. And he prescribed lithium carb. And ultimately, lithium carb cured his carditis. What made him a great teacher was that, like Herring, he truly understood the strict inductive method of Master Hahnemann. Ultimately, he studied under Herring and Bonnighausen, both of them. He said, the chief duty of prescriber is to base the treatment on the facts. Homeopathy believes the facts. Fact is always true. So we believe on the facts. The results of pure observation is most important. The result of, I think already you have studied or you have got knowledge from the inductive knowledge and deductive logic from your other philosophy club. I could not attend your classes because I took classes of last 2 years. Physically, I took classes, but due to some unavoidable circumstances, I compelled to stay at Calcutta. I will take regular class, seminar classes on Carol Dynam and Richard Hughes and also on the chronic diseases. And I will send the notes through email of the principal, and principal will print it and circulate through you, amongst you. Dunham, he was the most brilliant homeopath ever in history. And later he organized a World Homeopathic Convention, and which had a dream of so many persons of many years. He had a dreams of that observing the World Homeopathic Convention. And that convention was very much successful at that time. And after that, organizing the conference, he exhausted. And ultimately took bed in 1876 and passed away on February 18, 1877, at the age of 49 years. Very small age, no longer age. He died, but contributed beautiful to books, very helpful books in the faculty of homeopathy and so many writings. This is a short biography of Carol Dunham. Because you are not acquainted with Carol Dunham, already heard probably, but not on the classes, on the topics. Therefore, it is customary to speak on the... Now, what is the object of the homeopathy, the science of therapeutics? Now, object is to... conditions only possible some science of therapeutics to show that what is called rational medicine and to inquire in what degree they are fulfilled. The first topic, the first lesson, we should learn from the from his writings, the conditions of the therapeutics and what degree they are fulfilled the homeopathy. Because of that, in our daily practice and also the practice of so many stalwarts in Nagpur, I saw. And obviously you will see in your life that what is homeopathy or these are the way of the homeopathy. So therefore the conditions are to be observed, whether it is a homeopathy or not, in the name of homeopathy, so many things are going on at the present time in the present era. I do not like to disclose this one. In the long run, you will get your own knowledge, what is homeopathy, what is not. And another one is that to examine the methods by which his science may be most successful studied and made subservient art of medicine. Subservient art of medicines. The art of therapeutics. It is completely an art. I know that, I think you know about what is arts and what is science. So art of medicines is very much important. This is the two objects of writing of the books and writings of the therapeutics is subordinate to hygiene. The first chapter, if you go, analyze the series of cases. He demonstrated so many cases and written in this first chapter. You please go to this one. The homeopathy, the nature of therapeutics. The first one is the nature and limits of the science of therapeutics. The conditions of a science of therapeutics. Rational medicine fulfill all these conditions. These are the items on which he has discussed. He has written the books, that eight items. And has rational medicine accomplished nothing? Does homeopathy fulfill the condition of science of therapeutics? How to study the science of therapeutics? The study of Mathematica, a scheme for the study of the Mathematica. These are the topics, these are the items or subtopics are to be discussed. Has been discussed by Dunham in his own chapter. And it is my duty to interpret all the points. The nature and limits of the science of hygiene and therapeutics. Nature and limits of what he said. The therapeutic sometimes is subservient. What he told here, the susceptibility, living organism, certain general stimulus. This is very much important thing he has discussed. I know that you know about the susceptibility and what are the conditions. The two conditions are required for getting exposures of any stimulus, that susceptibility and sufficiently exposed. 3031 aphorism, if you go through this one. And this is the human biology to give response to any stimulus. And that stimulus, how you respond, that depends on your vitality and depend on your constitution. You are attending my class. All of you are, there are so many students are there, so many people have been joined from outside. That it necessitates the susceptibility and sufficiently disposed. These are two things. That susceptibility, as you learn from the Kent or J.N. Kanjilal or any other books, Hahnemann has not given any interpretation of susceptibility in details in Organon of Medicines. But thereafter, so many stalwarts like Kent and others. And few years back, Dr. J.N. Kanjilal has also given very nice interpretation of the susceptibility. Dr. B.K. Sarkar, in his voluminous book, he has interpreted it about the susceptibility. And the very much important thing, that the susceptibility, the living organism, it will respond to any stimulus on the depending on the two some conditions by which will respond a positive or negative way. That susceptibility, one is a sensitivity, other is a susceptibility. Dr. Jane Kanjil has expressed his views. One is sensitivity. We are listening the lecture and attending one. We are very much attending. and susceptibility, which will give any response in respect to the, we are, because the medical personnel, we are always concerned with the negative susceptibility. The positive susceptibility is the sensitivity. The negative susceptibility is nothing but the negative one, which concerned with the causes of disease or rather the manifestations of the disease, negative ways. Here's why very nicely certain general stimuli. The common stimuli that they are heat, cold, temperature, they are continually exposing. They are continually exposing to the different types of natural stimulus. I'm giving you. Someone is, even this normal temperature, catching cold. Out of the 20 or 25 students attending there, someone is using lot of warm clothes, mufflers and caps and other one. No, nothing is required for that. Why? The question of the negative susceptibility. In a family, the five brothers, the two are not susceptible to cold, but the one or two or other two are very susceptible to cold. Why? In the same family, same atmosphere, same parents. So this is the matter of thinking. I think you are the final students. You know about the susceptibility in details. And you please go through his topic, what he had discussed over there. The common stimulus are light, heat, electricity, elements. Elements means foods, elementary canal, the foods, atmospheric stimulus, etc. These are partly physical and partly psychical. Animals describe 31-30, to please the conditions. These are stimulus are partly physical and partly psychical. Even the psychical stimulus, that may causes disease. The physical stimulus, the light, heat, electricity, and elements, foods, and different types of atmospheric stimuli, these are the common stimulus, natural stimulus. These are physical, continually getting exposures. And according to the susceptibility and condition of the organisms, that depends on the susceptibility, how it remains, and what that condition of the life of the organism depends. And that depends on the constitution of the patients. Constitution of the patients. It needs interpretations with the help of animal's language. It needs clarifications, that conditions of living. The accompanying modalities or accessory circumstances. Approaching number 5, I think, already you have attended so many classes of your teacher by which you have gathered a knowledge of that. Now, health, death, and disease. These are the health. A person is healthy. That age, sex, mode of life, his constitutions, dispositions, everything depends on the many. In the young age, you are not susceptible. Someone is not susceptible. When the old age become very susceptible of the different types of stimulus and produces disease. He has described about the relative susceptibility. The disease or without constantly exist, don't exist. Because faculty of provision is supplementing a limited extent one stimulus by another's continuously. So this is the elasticity by which you can accommodate the stimulus, natural stimulus, that means your vitality, your constitution can accommodate it. And therefore you are not always disease, constantly fighting. The human biology says like this. Human biology always behaves like this. The vital force, the vitality. And he has, in these chapters, he has described the vis medica matrix naturae, the healing power of the nature. The nature is the best physician. That nature means human biology, not the outer nature. Hahnemann has described, Hahnemann has pointed out and mentioned in different part of the organon, especially introduction chapter written by Master Hahnemann. Consisting of 99 paragraphs and so many footnotes are there. It is included in your syllabus. It is first it was included in the MD course, but now it is included in your BSMS course. I used to take the class on introduction chapter into with the interpretation in the MD class. Now it is included. His medica matrix naturae. An introduction chapter and the preface written by Master Hahnemann. You please read it. Nature derived, the nature means the inner nature, not the outer nature. Inner nature means your biology, our biology, the human nature, not the nature that science that depends on the physics and chemistry or astronomy and others. The nature that the essential qualities or innate disposition which we got from the birth, that from the zygotes, from the very beginning, a cell that unicellular ultimately will be a multicellular ultimate human being consisting of multicellulars. And that from the innards, that from the very beginning, the impression what you got from the ovum and sperm and the zygote, it developed a full-fledged man. We are concerned with this nature. I am not a physicist or I am not a chemist that I will concern with the outer nature. I am a biologist, so I am concerned with the human nature. I am concerned with the, in modern language, the biotechnology or biological and genetics and others. Hahnemann told in a very abbreviated form, in a very short form, vital force, and thereafter he changes the vital principle. Why? You should think. Because at that time, the science was not developed. The atomic theory of Dalton, he just placed, not accepted. The father of the biology, father of the bacteriology, not born at that time. Louis Pasteur, Robert Koch are all after Master Hahnemann. At that time, the scientists knew that on the molecule is the unit of the matter. If you eat it, divides, it defeats, it broken. And molecule. And then molecule can be broken, the Dalton said, then atom. And the present science telling, no, atom, atom. We can go beyond that electronic configurations. During Hahnemann time, this type of knowledge was not available. The science was not so much developed. Because he was a philosopher, he told in a one sense, there is a vital force and vital principle. Means similar in biology, what we saw. Electronic microscope was not developed at that time. microscope was discovered. But now, what we know, at the time, during Hanumanian time, only cell, that unit of the cell is the unit, the protoplasm, nucleus. Now, the genetic genes are responsible. So he told, in one sense, in one word, that vital force, the disease phenomena that actually occurred in the nucleus, that it is in the new, that is in the genes. Today we are interpreting. It is our duty to interpret the vital force in the modern language. This, as a teacher of the science, as a teacher of the present science, it is our duty. As a teacher, what he saw, what he wrote. So his pedimetrius nature, what it is, that healing power of the nature. That depends on that lying of your, the nuclear level of your life, the molecular level of your life, that is the genetic level. Today I'm interpreting. So when we see, or when we study, when we teach the organon, it is my duty, it is our duty to interpret in the present sense. Busy being a student of science, you are the student of chemistry, just you have passed chemistry, physics, or biology. If you say vital force, but that vital, what is vital force? That should be interpreted in the modern language. Why Hanuman told vital force during that time? Because the nature of the science was not so much developed in the tune of the genetic theory, in tune of the nanotechnology in the matter. So gold is gold, null duty is molecule, null duty is atom. The gold duty is nuclear level. That becomes the electron, proton, neutron. Electron, proton, and neutron. If there is any change of the electron, proton, or neutron, what happened? The gold can be transmitted into the platinum. The iron can be transmitted into the gold. How? If there is a distribution of the periodic table of the electron, proton, and neutron. That knowledge was not available during Hanumanian time. So my students, fine. Any person challenge your allopathic friend, obviously will tell what you are learning, what you are telling about the vital force, vital force, vital force. It is your duty to interpret them. Why Hanuman told vital force in medical philosophy, the first medical philosophy in the world. That is, the organon is the first medical philosophy Hanuman wrote, Organon of Medicine. And that Organon of Medicine make a miraculous change of the allopathic streams. Ultimately, they left all the treatment they provided during that time. And therefore, the Adi Dajan, if you go through the introduction, the Hanuman, what he told in 1893, he wrote the introduction. One publisher's notes, you please go there, in the organon. What Hanuman told about the methods of treatment applied needs are not available. They change. The turning point made in their modern medicine after the introductions of the penicillin that was discovered in 1928, just last century. But before that, the treatment is adopted by them who know that everything from the Organon of Medicine. There are several examples he has given in the Hoan, two dissimilar meat. This is made together. And what are the disciplinary mode of method of treatment result that you understand. And also from the introduction chapter, we understand what are the methods adapted by them. This is not true. So the vital force at described to the philosopher and scientist like Master Hanuman, it is very much scientific. And the healing power lying within the level in the vital force, or genetic level, or molecular level. that interpretation. Otherwise, you may cram and commit and vomit. But we have to understand, you have to write down, you have to realize the logic of the organon of medicine with the help of the present science. So the Bhish meditated. Yes, written Dr. Carol Dhanap. And thereafter, he is told the special stimulus is nothing but the medicine. These are nothing but the homeopathic medicines. That special stimulus, that stimulus which can change in healthy condition, which also can change in the disease conditions. And that special stimulus, our medicines, that medicine, the changes during healthy conditions, we first understand, we grasp by drug proving, and we learn from Matria Medica, and we learn from our teachers. When they taught us during classes, Matria Medica classes on different stimulus. And these stimulus, when you apply in a disease conditions, and that it cured, nothing beside that cannot cure. There are so many stimulus are available, natural stimulus. The elements are also the natural elements. That food cannot cure. Food essential for us. Carbohydrate, protein, vitamins, minerals, fats are very much essential. If there is any deficiency, there might be some disease. And we can supplement, we can give some foods and that can develop, improve. But apart from that, that cannot cure. Even after supplying the vitamins, after supplying the carbohydrate, after supplying the when a person is suffering from marasmus, we are giving the protein, patient is developing health, but not fully. When you are stopping that one or stop this one, the supplement, that again the disease occurs. So there is some leak, and that leak is nothing but the miasmatic leak, that leak in the constitution, that leak in your own or the patient's health and dynamic, and that leak can only be repaired by this special stimulus. Application of the special stimulus. Otherwise not. These are essential. These are required by natural supplements should be supplied. But mind that, when there is, in spite of good foods, good thing, everything is good, but patient is suffering. Why? So there is something lacuna, that lacuna in the field of his own constitution, and that can only be supplemented by the special stimulus. This has been described by Master Dhanap in his topic. That special stimulus can only be applied. He has described here the fundamental principles of therapeutics. The fundamental principles of therapeutics. Mind that. You are telling about the therapeutics, the application side. The art of application. Homeopathy is the true natural healing art. The art intensifies by practice. You know very well how to play cricket, how to play bat, theoretically. You may be a good commentator. Ravi Shastri is a good commentator. Vogle was very good commentator. Now Sunil Gavaskar is a very good commentator. But the Sunil Gavaskar not only theoretical commentator to comment, give commentary on the cricket, he is also a good batsman. So he knew all the things how to play. Similarly in practice, the more practice, more apply more and more in your own practice from the student life, from the final year, try to apply your medicines in your home, in your house. Charity begins at the home. Try to apply. You know, because more than 300 drugs already you have studied from the first year to final year. How many drugs you have remembered? I do not know. Only for examination point of view, we'll study cram and vomit. We study more and more. Organon will see you all, give the direction how to apply the weapons. But you should know the weapons from the Matri Medica. Study Matri Medica more and more and apply. Failure is the pillar of success. You may fail. But ultimately, it will give some learning from to you. The failure gives some learning. That learning will be helpful for experiencing you in long run, in your own practice. So you study Matri Medica more and more. Daily. And apply in your art. That art, not arts. Arts, A-R-T-S means be a bachelor of arts, M-A, master of arts. That not art. That art is a skillful application of theoretical knowledge. And that is the art. Obviously developed on science. Every science has in an art. That art for the benefit of the humankind. Today's chemistry or today's physics is very much busy with the invention of hydrogen bomb or nuclear bomb or any other weapon, biological weapon or whatever might be it. Not for the destructions of the humankind. Not for the discredit of the nature. The corona, either is the Frankenstein or not. Frankenstein means the anything is prepared and which causes the detrimental to the originator or discoverer, the Frankenstein. If the China produces it, they are suffering today. So it is Frankenstein to them. That means artificially, that should not be for the detrimental to the humankind. So art, what they developed on the basis of science, so much developed today, science is so many, we are so much developed today. With the help of technology, I am talking with the Nagpur students. Now, the science is too much developed in the context of physics, chemistry, and biology. The biologists are thinking of the genetic engineering. What Hahnemann told in organomedicines, everything is on the base of science, based on science. What he observed, what he learned, what he taught from the science available during that time, 200 years back, he thought about the matter. Tum jab Shivaji ko life history, Shivaji ke contribution janega, tumko Shivaji ko मराठी को जानने के लिए तुमको शिवाजी को लाइफ हिस्ट्री पढ़ने चाहिए तब तुम शिवाजी को पहचानेगा सिमिलरली इफ यू वांट टू लर्न द होम्योपैथी इफ यू वांट टू लर्न एनीथिंग एनी साइंसेस यू शुड लर्न द कंडीशंस व्हेन इट वाज डेवलप्ड व्हाई ही रोट Why is the questions? So fundamental principles of therapeutics or some cardinal principles already you have obtained knowledge from the organometallurgical classes. Now, the great law of hygiene, causa, subletter, toliter, effector. My students, please take note of it. You write down in your notebook today, new word, causa, subletter, toliter, effectors. We know the causa sine qua non. We know the manifest exciting cause or causa occasionalis from the aphorism number 7. That occasional is the occasional cause of the disease. It is not the real cause in organon. It is not the real cause that promotes disease and maintains disease, never produce disease. What I say? In the context of causa subletter toliter effectors, this is our today's chapter of discussions. In the context, every word has an opposite word. Causa sine qua non. Causa sine qua non. Please write down. Causa sine qua non. Indispensable cause of the disease. In our parlance, in our language, in homeopathy, we consider the indispensable cause of the disease is the miasmatic cause, fundamental cause. Causa occasionalis, that causa occasionalis never produce disease, but it promotes disease and maintains disease. What I said? It promotes disease and maintains disease, never produces disease. Who produces disease? Causa sine qua non. What do you mean by causa sine? What is the English phrase? English meaning? That English meaning is indispensable cause of the disease. Similar. Causa subletter toliter effectors. We know CZ causa, CZ effectors. We know CZ effectors, CZ causa. That means if we remove the effect, automatically cause will go in our parlance. I will remove the cause by miasmatic treatment, miasmatic cause. Then automatically disease will cause. How will consider the miasmatic cause? On the basis of the effect, on the fact. Fact never betrayed. What I see, what I observe, that is a fact. So symptoms are the facts. Symptoms are the true guide for observing or finding out the fundamental cause. The causa subletter toliter effectors, if you remove the cause, then effect will go. It is not something contradictory to us, but it is a real thing. Being a practitioner, we should know the causa subletter toliter effectors in each and every case during practice life. During practice life, first you think of कब से हुआ है कैसे हुआ है पहले तो नहीं था सर नहीं था ये दो दिन से हुआ था कैसे हुआ था हाउ इट ऑकर्स व्हेन इट ऑकर्स यस गिवन कैरोल डनहम हैज गिवन सो मेनी केसेस सो आई विल इंटरप्रेट ऑल द केसेस वन बाय वन 6 cases. Stimulus, and thereafter, we will discuss the special stimulus of therapeutic agent. Yes, interpreted 6 cases. He is likewise a preserver of health. If he knows the things which causes the disease, and if he knows how it removes in persons in health, aphorism number 5, aphorism number 4, just after aphorism number 3, He is also a preserver of health. And two or three words is very important here. The things which causes disease. Number one, how to remove it. Number two, and persons in health. Plural, not person. That means mass, community-based approach. In Aphorism 3, he has described which are very essential to become a true practitioners of the healing art. Last sentence of the Aphorism 3. If he knows, if he perceives, clearly perceives what is to be cured in diseases, that is to say, each individual case of disease, knowledge of disease, indication. And he has given other points, application and others. And lastly, he told, then he has started the word if. If you have 100 rupees, you could purchase that particular gift or thing. If do not have, no. You will be a good practitioner of the healing art if he possesses, if you have, a physician has this particular knowledge, and thereafter, then he will be, and he also a preserver of health. Here in Master Hanuman, Aphorism 4 clearly stated about the community-based approach, persons in health. So you have to acquire in, finally you are gathering the knowledge of community medicine. From the first year, you are learning organon of medicine. It's just like topsy-turvy. Topsy-turvy means up and downwards. Head is low and tail is above. Topsy-turvy. पहले तुमको organon का knowledge हो गया, mathematics हो गया, बाद में तुम community medicine आ रहा है. तो patient को दे रहा है medicine. लेकिन पेशेंट तो कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन का तुमका नॉलेज तो नहीं है, फाइनल ईयर में गैदर करेगा. एनी हाउ मेट्रिमेडिक का तुम अच्छा, यू हैव गैदर गुड नॉलेज, बट ड्यू टू लैक ऑफ योर कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन नॉलेज, यू डू नॉट नो व्हाट आर द थिंग्स व्हिच कॉजेस द डिजीज. दैट इज द कम्युनिटी बेस्ड अप्रोच. First, starting your practice, you should knowledge, gather knowledge and community medicines. Causa, subletter, toliter, effects. Causa, sine qua non, baad mein discuss hoga. What are the factors that causes diseases? That factors might be in the form of manifest exciting cause. Hanuman, here in Aphorism number 7, please, if you have organon of medicine, open organon of medicine, I do not know how many you have. And my class will go, please bring this book. Number 1, organon of medicine. Number 2, Carol Dunham book. Please, please, please. Always I used to say in my classes, physical classes, when I used to take two. Please open Aphorism 7. What he has written? Manifest exciting. Please wait for it 1 minute. Aphorism 7, in this context, I would like to discuss that now as in diseases, from which no manifest exciting cause और मेंटेनिंग कॉस्ट, कॉस्ट ऑकेशनली हैज टू बी रिमूव्ड, वहां पे एक फुट नोट है, फुट नंबर 3 और फुट नोट नंबर 1 ऑफ द एपोरिज्म 7 एंड टोटल फुट नोट 15 नंबर 3, प्लीज ओपन. मैनिफेस्ट एक्साइटिंग कॉस्ट, दैट कॉस इज विजिबल, दैट कॉस इज पैल्पेबल एंड कॉस इज रिमूवल. आंखों में देख सकता है, टच कर सकता है, उसको रिमूव कर सकता है. व्हाट इट प्रोड्यूसेस, प्लीज गो थ्रू द फुट नोट, प्लीज गो थ्रू द फुट नोट. इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी टू एवरी इंटेलिजेंट फिजिशियन फुट फर्स्ट रिमूव इट Where it exists, जहां पे है उसको इंटेलिजेंट फिजिशियन पहले रिमूव करेगा, पहले रिमूव करेगा. द इंडिस्पोजिशन देयर अपॉन जनरली सीजेस डिजीजेस, सीजेस स्पॉन्टेनियसली. तो तुम लोग अभी कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन का नॉलेज गैदर किया है, तुम लोग मेट्रियोमेडिका, बहुत मेट्रियोमेडिका मेडिसिन स्टडी ऑलरेडी कर लिया, कर चुका है. आई थिंक सिलेबस, इन द टोटल सिलेबस विल कवर्स मोर देन 300 ड्रग्स मेट्रियोमेडिका. तुमको पल्सेटिले का नॉलेज है, नासभूमिका का नॉलेज है, बहुत सारा का है, पॉलिकस रेमेडी है. इन ए प्रैक्टिस फर्स्ट यू शुड नो the things which causes disease and causes disease and how to remove it. Persons in health, so that knowledge is very essential for you for the approach of doing practice. That knowledge which produces disease, what ear says, that manifest exciting cause, it is my interpretation that is palpable, visible, palatable and it is removable. Manually तुम उनको remove कर सकता है, इसको manifest करता है, वो क्या तैयार करता है, indisposition. This aphorism is very much important for us being a beginners who want to do practice. Then thereafter he will know the cause of sine qua non. Thereafter, he will go through the practice. So, my students, I do not like to linger my lecture today. That part, very next day, you please come on in proper time. I will interpret on the aphorism 7 and case as given by Carol Dunham one by one. There are 6 cases. How he has interpreted causa, sublator, tollator, effectors. You remove it, automatically it will go. If first, you will gather the knowledge.